In today's video, I want to go back to the old fantasy battles that I used to cover here on the channel and have some fun with this one. Now, this video is going to be a bit convoluted. There are going to be several different outcomes to this battle, so I want you to stay tuned and listen closely. Anakin Skywalker, the Chosen One. He had the potential to be the most powerful Jedi in existence until his untimely demise at the hands of his former master, Obi-Wan Kenobi, who chopped him up on Mustafar and left him to burn alive, only to become a fraction of the man that he was destined to become. George Lucas has claimed that Vader only became 80% as powerful as the Emperor after he got burned up, and for this reason, never could properly beat him one-on-one. Now, you might be wondering how Vader killed the Emperor then in Return of the Jedi. The answer is because Palpatine's focus and hatred on killing Luke completely tunneled him from seeing Vader's betrayal, and once Vader grabbed him, his anger exemplified as he blacked out in a Sith fit of rage, shooting lightning all over the place as he threw Palpatine over the railing. Now, had Anakin not lost to Obi-Wan, how powerful would he have become? Well, he'd be the most powerful being in the galaxy, forever. He was the Chosen One. That's how his character was written. That's what makes him a tragedy. Starkiller, on the other hand, was the epitome of Luke Skywalker's full potential had he been trained by Darth Vader and had the story basically been about Luke. His ability to stop a Star Destroyer, his ability to send a shockwave outwards from his body and incinerate all those around him, his immense speed and precision were all feats of the Force that burnt Anakin could never do. Now, in the game Force Unleashed and Force Unleashed 2, he fights Vader and wins. It wasn't an easy battle, but it definitely ended in his favor. So we know what would have happened had he found Vader, but this video is about Anakin at his full potential fighting Starkiller. Now, had Annie not lost to Kenobi, had he not burned up, we would have reached his potential, and we would have seen a very, very powerful Anakin Skywalker. Annie at his true potential would have killed Starkiller, no doubt in my mind whatsoever. However, we've never actually seen Anakin at his true potential, so we must then focus on Anakin just before he lost to Obi-Wan, fighting Starkiller. So okay, had these two been pitted against one another on Mustafar or somewhere else, it would have been a terribly close battle. In the comics and the books, legends and canon, Anakin's Force abilities were really shown properly. However, in the movies, we didn't really get to see them in all their glory. For example, in Legends material, the first time Anakin killed someone in front of Obi-Wan was by combusting them into flames. This kind of power is next to that of a fully powered mage, or wizard in other words. Anakin in Revenge of the Sith against Starkiller would lose. Starkiller was just too powerful in the Force. Now, this doesn't mean Anakin is out for the count. There is another different scenario that I'll explain in a few minutes regarding how he could actually win. If it were a battle of lightsaber combat, then Anakin might have the upper hand, but again, I gotta give it to Starkiller. He was just too ferocious, too fast, and too powerful for Anakin at this point in his life. Remember, if Anakin reached his potential, he would dust Starkiller no problem. Well, maybe not no problem, but it would be pretty easy. Annie had just turned to the dark side, and he didn't get enough time to really own his new fighting skills and powers. And yeah, I'm saying his new fighting skills because Hayden Christensen in the bonus DVD of Revenge of the Sith even says that Anakin's entire fighting style is different once he turns to the dark side. Now, I hope that we'll one day get more of an elaboration on that, but until then, that's all we've got to go off of. So, Vader vs. Starkiller, Starkiller wins. Anakin full potential vs. Starkiller, Anakin wins. Anakin Revenge of the Sith vs. Starkiller, Starkiller wins. However, and this is a big however, Anakin in Revenge of the Sith versus Starkiller, but protecting Padme is a completely different story. See, when Anakin has emotions mixed into his fighting, he's a very different fighter. He's almost like the Hulk. The more angry you make him, the more powerful he becomes. The more he taps into that rage. He doesn't use the light side or the dark side, rather he just uses the Force. In the novel against Dooku, as Dooku taunted him, he started hurling tables at the Count, throwing things and beams from across the room with the Force. He was relentless and very powerful. The amount of energy that Anakin expels when something emotional is fueling him, or something is at stake, yields a completely different person and Force user. For example, again, in episode 2, which isn't near the potential of Anakin in episode 3 or the power level of Anakin in episode 3, when his mother died, in the novel, he was going berserk. He used Force speed, he crushed sand people with the Force, he threw boulders over them, he just sliced and diced at immense speeds while he was running through the village. The things he did was brutal, and you can find the video on my channel at your convenience. Now, I believe if Starkiller, for whatever reason, had Padme captured with the intent to kill or hurt her, Anakin would tap into this reservoir of all the midichlorians that he had, all 20,000, and unleash godlike powers we have never seen before. Some might argue that Anakin did this against Obi-Wan. Correct, he did. However, it was his own arrogance that defeated him, and it was against his master, Obi-Wan Kenobi, who he was trying to prove a point to, that made him lose. The poetry behind Anakin's loss wasn't just that he lost to his arrogance or the high ground, but rather, he tried to beat Kenobi at his own move against Darth Maul. The same way Obi-Wan killed Maul is the same way Anakin wanted to kill Kenobi. He was just making a statement, not to just his power in general, but to the fact that he was so much better than Obi-Wan, that he would insult him by killing him with this very same move that he killed the first Sith to appear in 1,000 years. Now, Anakin trained with a droid in the temple training grounds and programmed this droid to look, move, and act like Darth Maul. This is the one from one of the previous comics that I've covered many moons ago. Obi-Wan explained to Mace and Palpatine from the balcony, as they admired and watched Anakin fight the Zabrak droid, that Anakin had asked about every single detail regarding Maul for years, and how Obi-Wan fought and killed him. Anakin was hellbent and obsessed on proving the point that he was more powerful than Kenobi in every single way, and that he was always being held back by his master. So, if Starkiller put Padme's life in danger in front of Anakin's eyes, then I believe Anakin would unleash some rage and power like he had never done before. Anakin has a way with using his emotions. They definitely get the best of him, but like I said, he's like the Hulk. When he gets more angry, he just becomes more powerful. Starkiller wouldn't die easily, but I do believe Anakin, with the right motive and emotion, would have been unstoppable. So long as he didn't become arrogant, which I don't think he would have if he found anyone other than Kenobi who he was trying to prove a point to. Any Skywalker would win in certain specific scenarios, but even then, it would be extremely difficult. But I do believe he would win in the end if Padme were in danger in front of his eyes. At least, maybe. Not all in one piece either. You know, maybe, you know, he loses a couple limbs. That's kind of Anakin's destiny anyways. Thanks for watching this one. I hope you have a great day. May the Force be with you always. As Padme's ship landed, she stepped out to meet Anakin when he looked up to see Obi-Wan and Plo Koon standing in the opening of the ship's extended plank. Their silhouettes almost godlike as the light cast a shadow, illuminating their outline, embossed in the red blaze of the red bubbling lava. Anakin yelled at Padme, choking her, until Plo, who was much more quick to stop this than Obi-Wan, jumped in the air and shot Force Judgment onto Anakin. This was Plo's equivalent to Sith Force Lightning. However, not as powerful, it still hurt Anakin enough to stop his attack on Padme. As he let go, she stumbled backwards and ran up to Obi-Wan. This angered Vader even more. The betrayal he felt was compounded only with hatred he couldn't even compare to the heat of the planet's melting core. As he ignited his lightsaber in unison to Obi-Wan and Plo, the battle began. Sidious frowned at Yoda as he watched his royal red guards fall to the floor. Yoda and the three Jedi Masters entered his office, all igniting their lightsabers. Palpatine.